Hi, my name is Simran Kisilsahu. I'm a bioinformatics researcher based out of Bangalore, India. So today I'll be presenting SigBioSciENE. This is a standalone interactive application for detecting biological significance on a gene set. So today's outlines are like what is detecting biological significance on a gene set means, some of the available resources for doing so, an ideal scenario for a gene set analysis, SigBioSciENE's overview, some of its features, how to use it, and a demo, and followed by some modular design for developers. So what is biological significance on a gene set means? So from any hydroport sequence analysis, during the analysis or towards the end, we generate a set of genes or a cluster of genes. For example, in a typical transcriptomic experiment, we generate a list of differential expressed genes, which on further analysis gives us a better understanding of the biological significance. So over the years, different methods have been developed, such as SGSEA, ORA, NTA, and few others. For doing this kind of analysis, there are a lot of great resources available, such as MCTV, Enricha, GProfiler, DriveRate. Let's consider some ideal scenarios for doing a gene set analysis. So it needs an organism database, which need to be up to date. Sometimes it requires a model and non-model organisms as well. And one main thing is reproducibility. This can be done using database version tracking and statistical keeping a log of statistical iterations. And it's better to have programmatic access so that it can be integrated with any kind of workflows. And it need to have need to give some rich plots, so it will help us better understand interpreting the results. Well, most of the available resources support some of AOC criteria, but not everything. So here comes SigBioSciENE. So this is completely based on open source infrastructure, such as Bioconductor. So it basically have two components to it. One is Bioconductor's annotation hub web resources and Bioconductor packages. So Bioconductor's annotation hub resources collect annotation data from different resources such as Ensemble, Geontology, Keg, NCBI. And on top of this databases, we use the Bioconductor packages such as Cluster Profiler, Annotation DBI to do the analysis. So SigBioSciENE structures somewhat looks like this. You need to input the organism's name or ID, and you need to put a gene list, if possible full gene also. Then it downloads the particular organism and it makes suitable inputs for different modules. Then there are different modules such as like ID mapping, gene ontology, cake pathway enrichment, and more. So some of the features are downloading selected organism from a database and gene ID mapping and gene ontology enrichment, genes in a cake pathway, enrichment plots. A few things are work in progress, like directly launching from DSeq to object, the reproducible R script. Sorry. So how to use it? It can be downloaded as a R package or a single R script for SciENE server deploy, or it can be run from a Docker container. So let's consider a demo. So here, this is how you input your gene list organism, then you submit. So it takes a while to download the database and do the background calculations. So then it gives like how many genes passed and ID mapping and different kind of gene ontologies and respective plots. Same goes with your KK pathway also. And this is PathView package, like which stores your genes on KK pathways. Yeah, so we are migrating to a new UI, so this will help us better adding the new modules to this application. So yeah, in such a way it becomes easy for the developer to integrate a new module, which can be very much helpful. Thank you. So here are a few links where you can reach me on your feedback, or if you want to contribute, please feel free to do so. And these slides are available under this URL. Thank you again.